Hi guys, bonsoir, this is Sharik and welcome back to another lesson with Globetrot with Arabic. This is going to be a Lebanese Arabic lesson to my Lebanese Arabic students. And guess what? Today is day 7 in our 30-day challenge. As I promised you, I will try to upload a lesson for 30 days every single day. So I'm challenging myself to do this. And just like I'm challenging myself, let me ask you guys to challenge yourselves as much as you can to try to follow these lessons and study every day. And of course, if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to leave your questions in the comment box below. I will try my best to answer all of them. Before we begin, let me, as usual, ask you to subscribe to my channel if you find my lessons useful. Also follow me on Facebook at Globetrot with Arabic and on Instagram at Globetrot with Arabic, because I do upload lessons there as well. And whenever we record videos together, I go there and I sometimes put the list of words or the sentences that we have used in the lessons. So it would be also useful if you follow me on those platforms as well. Yesterday we began our grammar lesson in Lebanese Arabic. We spoke about the demonstratives in Lebanese Arabic, but we only used affirmative sentences. Today is part two of the same lesson, but this time we will talk about the questions using demonstratives. So if you didn't watch my lesson yesterday, what you can do is go to that lesson. I will put the link also in the description box or somewhere up on the screen now. If you click on it, you will find it. You can do part one first and then you can come back to do part two, which is today's lesson. One more request before we begin our lesson. Press pause and go grab a pen and paper, because I think it's very important that you guys write everything that you are hearing, because I believe to learn a language, there are many elements involved, and one of the elements is to write things down, because your brain memorizes things. Also, to keep repeating after me, keep pressing pause, repeat, pause, repeat. Do some parrot work, because if you say it, you write it, you see it, and you're looking at the images and all these combinations, you're hearing it at the same time. These will help you memorize what we are doing faster and learn Arabic much faster. Okay, let's begin. All right, guys, we will start with a quick revision. So, هيدي سيارة, يعني this is a car. هيدا بيت, يعني this is a house. هيدي كرسي, يعني this is a chair. هيدي طاولة, يعني this is a table. هيدا شباك, this is a window. هيدا باب, this is a door. هيدي بنت, this is a girl. هيدا صبي, this is a boy. هيدا شاب, this is a young man. هيدي صبية, this is a young woman. هيدول فواكه, these are fruits. هيدول تياب, these are clothes. Now, we will start asking questions in relation to the same pictures that we saw up there. So we will begin by saying the first one, شو هيدا؟ شو هيدا؟ If we break this down, it literally means what this. So we don't have what is this. We don't have a verb to be in the present form in Arabic. It's like you're saying what this. شو هيدا؟ What is this? Now, even if the answer is a feminine word, like in this case, yesterday we said, هيدي سيارة, this is a car. But because when you ask what is this, you wouldn't know what is it. So you wouldn't know if it's masculine or feminine, right? That's why I prefer if we ask the question in the masculine form. Even if the answer is هيدي سيارة, it doesn't matter. The question should be شو هيدا؟ شو هيدا؟ And you would answer هيدي سيارة. شو هيدا؟ هيدا بيت. You see, it's the same question regardless of what your answer is, feminine or masculine. شو هيدا؟ هيدي كرسي. Now, another way to ask a question. So here I asked, what is this? Here I asked, what is this? شو هيدا؟ And here also I asked, what is this? Now I'm gonna ask a yes-no question. هيدي طاولة؟ So you notice what I did is that I simply changed my voice. Now, I'm gonna tell you two things. One of them is a statement and another is a question. You have to guess which one is the statement and which one is the question. Heidi Tauli. Heidi Tauli. And the second one is Heidi Tauli. Heidi Tauli. Now, which one is the question? The second one is the question because I'm adding that musical sound in the end. Heidi Tauli, that's a question. Heidi Tauli, that's a statement. So in order to form a yes-no question in Arabic, simply all what you need to do is change your voice and say Heidi Tauli. So in English, for example, you would have to add is this a table? In Arabic, nothing changes. The statement stays the same. We just change the tonality of our voice and we say Heidi Tauli, like in this case. Okay, let's go to the next one, which is a window. And in this case, I wrote something extra. If you notice, I said here, Heida shabik shi. Heida shabik shi. So, one way of asking a question, a yes-no question, is just Heida shabik, is this a window? Now, a Lebanese way of doing this is by adding the word she. Literally, she means something. It's like you're saying, is this a window something? Of course, it doesn't make sense in English when you say that. But it's like you're saying, is this a window at all? It's like you're double checking if it's a window or not, okay? So this she, you can either include it or not. So you can say Haida shabik, or you can also say Haida shabik she. It's like here when you are saying the she, there's an emphasis on double checking or something. Is it or it's not? Okay, so Haida shabik she, Haida babe she. Again, you can also say just Haida babe. And then this she here literally means something. You can cross it out. Heida babe or Heida babe she. You're not sure. Maybe you're thinking it's a window or a door and you're double checking and you're asking your friend, is it a door or a window? So Heida babe she at all. Now, when it comes to asking about people, I'm not going to say obviously shu Heida because it's not a thing. It's a human being. I have to say مين هيدا or مين هيدي. In this case, I'm saying مين هيدي لأنه the word, the picture that you have here is a feminine picture, which because it's a girl in this case basically. So مين هيدي, who is this? مين هيدي. Again, there's no is in Arabic. It's like you're saying who this, who is this, مين هيدي. Now, if it's masculine, let's say, for example, if I'm asking about this little boy here, I should say, مين هيدا? مين هيدا? Who is this? Now, مين هيدا? Again, because it's a guy, basically. So, مين هيدا? And for the young woman, مين هيدي? By the way, I can also abbreviate هيدي and say هاي instead. مين هاي? I wrote two A's here, but I don't really pronounce it hi. No, I'm kind of pronouncing it min hey. If you speak French, you would know that it kind of sounds like this accent grave, hey, rather than hi, okay? So min hey or min heidi, who is this? And you can also use the hey, not only in the question, of course, in the statement. For example, if you want to say this is a girl, hey binet. You can say hey binet or heidi binet. And finally, if it's a plural word, you will say شو هيدول, هيدول. And then you're asking شو. So you're saying what these. You are not saying what are these. There's no are in Arabic. So you're saying just what these, شو هيدول. And the abbreviation of هيدول would be هول. شو هول. I can say both. شو هيدول or شو هول. Okay? And هيدول تياب شي. I can use it with the plural as well. I don't only say, for example, هيدا باب شي or هيدي سيارة شي. I can use it with the masculine, with the feminine. But here I'm also using it with the plural. هيدول تياب شي. are these clothes at all? It's like you're double checking she. So this she, you can either include it or not. Especially you can use it when you are not sure about something and you want to find out if it's right or wrong. Okay? So let's quickly repeat our questions. So as I said, شو هيدا؟ هيدي سيارة. شو هيدا؟ هيدا بيت. You can find the answers in the previous lesson if you want. شو هيدا؟ هيدي كرسي. شو هيدا؟ هيدي طاولة. Or I can say هيدي طاولة. And the answer would be إيه هيدي طاولة. Or نعم, if you want to be polite, to say نعم. So basically إيه means yeah. إيه. And نعم means yes. إيه or نعم. إيه or نعم. So you know, growing up, your mom tells you, oh, we don't say yeah, we say yes. Maybe they used to tell us the same thing when we were kids. Like, ما منقول إيه, we don't say إيه. منقول نعم, we say نعم. But of course, you can use both now interchangeably, okay? So in this case, I said, هيدي طاولة, and my answer would be, إيه هيدي طاولة, or نعم هيدي طاولة. هيدا شباك شي؟ I will answer, إيه هيدا شباك. هيدا باب شي؟ And my answer will be, إيه هيدا باب. مين هيدي؟ هيدي بنت. ومين هيدا؟ هيدا صبي. مين هيدا؟ هيدا شاب. مين هيدي؟ Or مين هاي؟ هيدي صبية. Of course, you can ask about these when you're already seeing these are boys and girls or young men or a young woman. But if you're asking who's this person that you don't know, I don't know. For example, if you spot your boyfriend talking to a girl and you want to know who she is, you can put your hand here and say "min hai" with that, you know, with that face, "min hai" or "min haida." And then your friend explains to you, "Oh, this is whoever." Okay. Now, شو هيدول؟ هيدول فواكه. Or I can also say, شو هول؟ What are these? هيدول فواكه. هيدول تياب شي؟ هيدول تياب شي؟ Are these clothes at all? إيه هيدول تياب. Or نعم هيدول تياب. Okay guys, I think that's it for today. I'm not going to continue with the negatives. I will continue with the negative sentences tomorrow. I have them here already prepared and we will talk about these tomorrow. For today, what you can do is write down in the comment box below these questions as they are and answer them as well. And also you can go to the previous lesson we did yesterday, like this one, هيدي سيارة, هيدا بيت, هيدي كرسي, هيدي طاولة. You can also write them down. I will turn my camera and say bye to you right now. See you. All right, guys, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. And stay tuned for tomorrow's lesson. We will talk about demonstratives in negative sentences. So make sure to study well if you have the time. And also, who knows, you can do the homework and leave it in the comment box below. Maybe you can even record yourself and tag yourself. I know this is something not easy. It took me time to get used to the camera and sometimes I'm still not even used to it. But if you can try, it's gonna be a challenge for you. We can all push each other to become better and learn better. So whoever wants to do that, feel free to tag me with your posts on either on Instagram or on Facebook at Globetrot with Arabic. See you tomorrow. Bye.